Rajiv Saxena ji has been of great
help and has been helping us with all these arrangements and everything, and we have been constantly in touch with them. And at the last, I would like to thank Mr. Khatri,
who has been helping us in our arrangements and all.
You know, it's the last session. Everybody would be in the mood to, you know, let this get over and go for go free sightseeing and all.
But
I also understand that it's a very important session for all of you, because besides health, money is also a very important factor, particularly after retirement. And hence, I'm
very sure
that I have a full attention of you all in my delegation. We got
the session.
It was about financial planning after retirement. You have all have been successful, all have passed you know, your career or near retirement of your career. You have seen ups and downs, as Mr. Sarkar
covered. In
your career, you have been dealing with money. So I don't know
to what extent
we will be of help. Here, before I talk about payouts and savings, I would like to touch upon time, though I understand the earlier speakers have already talked about. But some of my friends who have retired, I've seen them doing nice things, that someone has taken some teaching in some colleges, institutes. Maybe they don't get big money, but some get car, big driver, some get some facility, and with some little money, but by that process they are able to keep themselves up to date, fit, and are able to use their time productively. Every person could be different. So what we are trying to do, we are trying to make four situations. And four, no financial commitment and no wealth. Along with this, we have our retirement fund, which will be getting in also. So the whole thing one will have to look at on individual basis. But concepts will remain the same. So what we are trying to talk about here, I'm giving you a summary of what I'm talking about. And the purpose of this summary is that you all should get a feel that what will take you to invest towards. The questions which you need to frame could be, if they are relating to a presentation, they could be asked there and then. And if they are independent of the presentation and that particular topic, then you can ask them at the end of the presentation, so that it's for the benefit of everyone. What we are talking about here is about financial planning. And from financial planning, we'll be moving to wealth planning, because financial planning is very, very basic. We'll talk about some key concepts of wealth planning, because anything we talk of management, until at least we understand some basic concepts which are related to that, we will not be able to appreciate how that needs to be handled. And the next question which I'm also raising is, which I raised at not many great form, is wealth for all. And particularly people who have good wealth, this becomes a very, very relevant subject. Because people having wealth to meet their day-to-day commitments, this may not be that relevant, but a lot of people have wealth more than what they need. Then this question becomes very, very important. We are going to talk about various asset distribution from this point of view, because wealth management is nothing but allocating your various assets under different asset classes. So we talk about different asset classes with their indicative returns, what kind of returns we can expect from different asset classes. We talk about pros and cons of various asset classes, because every asset class comes with its own hassles and own simplicity. We talk about different asset classes, their return on long-term basis. Our analysis has shown that if you look at asset class for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years basis, the returns can be totally different, and risk associated with that asset class can be totally different Then when you are investing them on 1 month basis, 1 year basis, or 3 year basis. Certain asset classes like property and all, it doesn't make sense to invest for the short term because the cost of transition is very, very high. We are talking about comparison of various asset classes in terms of their compounded annual growth. We'll be talking about power of compounding and power of discipline. And discipline is needed in every part of life. Financial management, wealth management also requires strong discipline. People with discipline only. Thank you.
That question is still has to be proven.
Sir, I agree with two things.
In principle, I agree with you. But it has to be proven that he loses it.
See, the question again, I just take for 2 minutes into this point because it's important that we understand. See, I was talking to somebody, an astrologer, 20 years back, and he was predicting certain things. And he says, such and such person's time will be very good. Then I said, what is the meaning of very good? He said, yeah, bhikari hai, to usko 100-200 rupaye mil jayenge. So that's a good time. Raja hai, to wo samrat ban sakta hai. Agar wo wealthy hai, to bahut wealthy ban jayega. Job mein hai, to kuch uski promotion ho jayegi. So this good is also a relative term. When we talk about, you may not become a pauper. You may still have 1,000 crore. You may still have 5,000 crore. But the important thing is, when we say he has destroyed wealth, so if his wealth would have been 20,000 crore or 50,000 crore and if reduced to 5,000 crore, the position and prestige, like the king of good times, in his own words he says, that I have been the king of good times and now I am the king of bad times.
Yes.
You see, everybody loves his DNA. So children are the most soft point for everyone in their life. Investing for children's business is a very common thing I've seen in investing, where people, you know, felt, you know, totally during or, you know, lost. And even the children get lost because they feel that they are responsible for their parents' situation. Maybe buying, you know. I leave that as a judgment, you know. I'm talking about from my experience of the last 37 years because I've been involved with not many, my, you know, association is more with industries and people with business and not with, you know, banks or service class people. But what I've seen.
Yes,
No, I'm not saying that.
But nowadays our children don't need our money.
Absolutely, I'm coming to that. That's the reason I started with the fact that no commitment. No commitment means no commitment. Because most of the, see, today's time, most of the people have 1 or 2 children, and most of them are overseas. And by this age, all are set. But I'm still taking certain people who might have late children, who might have other difference of money. Situation of every person to be. I'm only trying to reflect. When I come on that, I explain to you what I mean, you know, by this. I'm talking about reverse mortgage, we talk about systematic vision, withdrawal plan. I'm also adding one slide, how to create that. Though, may not be very relevant here, but it's never too late. And plus, dear children, you might like to see and love, which was wanted to do, but still maintain the same life standard. So that passive income, to a large extent, takes care of the subject. So, we are saying identify all potential income and potential expenses, which may be required to be incurred. Maybe just take some budget, maybe for 5 years, 10 years, draw them in a very simple vertical form, or whatever form one is used to. Based on the box, calculate your revenue and expense and make budget. The most important part, you see, certain expenses and certain income are established, like the pension. established. One person, yesterday evening, the lovely dinner we had, the program we had, I happened to talk to one of the participants, and he was talking about commuting pension, and the question he said is, suggest in tomorrow's presentation, should we commute the pension or we should not commute the pension? I'm going to address that later, but the thing which is important is that certain incomes are clear. Certain incomes we know, like pension, it's going to come. If people have rentals and all, they will come. If people have certain investments or certain expenses which are there, they will come. So they will know that in their monthly things, do we have surplus or do we have short. The key which comes is, what is the lump sum money? The past money and the present lump sum money one is going to get at the time of retirement. What do we do? And how do we ensure that this money helps us to fill the gap if we have a gap, or if we have surplus already, then this money is deployed in such a way that one is able to leave a legacy. Finally, what for? One accumulates wealth. At the end of the day, it goes for legacy. Because again, as I said, everybody loves their DNA, everybody loves their children. So finally, it goes for them. The investment for meeting the short-term gap is different, and the criteria are different. The instrument and asset class would be different. While the instrument and asset class could be different if you are going to leave it for life. If you do not need that money for your own cash flow requirement. So again, as I said, it will depend on each and every individual. It is individual case, and we need to see in everybody's case, what is the bottom line? Is it short or the other? Thus, are our children competing to handle those complexities? Maybe we can handle, but if children can't handle, it is time for us to get what is missing. So when we talk about selection of asset class in their issue, we talk about documentation, risk, hassles, return, everything is based on that and the individual psyche of the person. When I deal with people, I find people who want simplicity to the last extent. They are looking for plain vanilla product. And there are people who are looking for more return. Maybe they are willing to spend more time. So it depends on the individual psyche also what he likes, what he wishes. Psychological peace is a very important part of wealth. Because as I said earlier, what wealth is it? Finally, the life is about happiness and being peaceful. So psychological factor also has to be looked at while managing the wealth. Tax, again, is a very important. In our week, as per your knowledge. I am talking about three key concepts of wealth management. The concept of risk reward. I think I don't need to explain much on risk reward. As I said, discipline is needed in every part of life. Financial management or wealth management is no risk. My colleague Shikha, when she runs through the detailed presentation and runs through some numbers, she will reflect you that if 5,000 rupees saved every month at the age of 25, even taking a CAGR of 12% or 15%, can make a figure of around 2 crores to 3.5 crores at the age of 60. So the power of consistent investment and the power of time is a very important part of wealth creation. Something has passed, but still not over. As I said, we still have 15 years more to go. So we are trying to play here, and she'll talk about. We are talking about situations where, if we have surplus from our cash generation, how wisely we should invest that money, so that after 15 years, we again have substantial wealth. Because 10 years, 12 years, we may still enjoy what we have. After that, the wealth will have a different meaning and will be used for different purposes. The second, there was no buyer. I'm not sure in this room how many of such people have faced this problem, but my experience with my crimes have been horrible. So simple and easy. Everybody would have taken a terminal, would have sat on that, and we, instead of doing any business on us, would have only been punching him and a second that he would have been going with it. It doesn't happen. Jain will see a PC call and I have to buy my account. But you go to advise. Everybody will advise you at least.
Go. retired from State Bank of India. He says he is, for the last 5 years, trading every day. Yes, there are days he makes losses, but he says every month for the last 5 years, he has made some money. He says the highest profit may be 15,000 a month, the lowest profit may be 1,000 rupees a month. He says he makes money. He says more importantly, it keeps him engaged from 9 to 3 or something like that. And, if, and because of that, because he's doing trading, he's reading also on the internet, you know, all these advisories and so many people. So it keeps him busy. He gives him some amount of money, not huge money, because he says his risk-taking ability is also very limited. And he has been persuading me, because I have retired already in October, he's been persuading me, please, you also do this. Discipline is very important. He says he has got limits for everything. Beyond which he will not do.
But it is okay, it is limited.
Yeah.
Now, discipline
is going to left. No, he doesn't do it. He knows, he says, I've got a risk capital which is for trading only.
Yeah.
His investment would be separate, he says, which he doesn't touch.
Yes, people have a degree. Then you don't. I think what your friend is right, and what your friend is saying is right. In fact, my research analysts and all. And you start seeing right at 6 o'clock in the market so that you start knowing what's happening in the world. Totally different. The most important thing in these things are this. The speculative tendency. And there's an old saying. You win in a casino, like Jeetawa Jawari bhi double marked hai, or Harawa Jawari bhi double marked hai. Because Harawa, you would say double kar rahe. तो जीता हुआ तो उसे आदत है मैं तो जीतूंगा ही इज कॉन्फिडेंट इसलिए दिस स्पेकुलेटिव टेंडेंसी कम इन मोस्ट आई
डू आई एम ऑलवेज लाइक इज स्कैर्ड ऑफ डूइंग दिस नो बट आई एम एबल टू बाय दिस
इज नो शी
सेज दैट इज वेरी
वेरी सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी द प्रॉब्लम दिस इज सर दिस इज सर एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल डीलर्स एंड ट्रेडर्स इज दैट सर दिस एडिक्शन
But this guy was in treasury.
Yeah, that is the problem. That's the problem is the
addiction.
It's
an addiction.
And the fear. People don't sell at loss. And they don't take profit also.
No, but so what he says, I go by his statement, but I have no means of corroborating what he says.
Yeah.
He says, I deal every day. Most days I make money. There are days I have lost money. But my maximum profit in a month has been 15,000 rupees, not more than that. Because he says I have set limits for trading.
Maximum loss?
He says in a month, he's never had a month of loss. There are days of losses.
In a month,
but his lowest profit was 500 a month. His maximum profit was 15,000 a month. He has set limits for everything, he says. And his investment book is separate. Trading book is separate. What is there in investment book, he doesn't trade. That is, he says, for long term. This is for daily spending time, keeping himself active, and his mind is very,
absolutely
very active.
In fact, we have got.
And he's, I'm telling you, he says in Trivandrum, he says there is no other interest there. There's no other interest. I have.
And those people then spend a lot of time in reading balance sheets, reading things, and you know they're perfect in their mind and head.
Yeah.
Perfect. The question is, can you have that discipline? Will you be able to resist greed, like you said? But it gives me a kick. You know? But then, another aspect of this is that it shoots your blood pressure up and down. Market ke saath, aapka mood deflect kar jata hai. Market upar hoti hai, to thoda chehre se wo ronak nazar aati hai. Market thoda sa wo down ho, और मशीन में लाइन लाल चार दिन से चल रहे तो थोड़ा सा डिप्रेशन आने शुरू हो
गया. I see, I was in US. US already there was this or not.
Unit, one typical example. At the end of the day, anything which is unit, I said, you have a question. You all are buying from it. You have seen that. If he says, मैं आपको 15% return दे दूँगा या 20% return दे दूँगा, कहाँ से दे? You talk about PE, you talk about you know, real estate funds, you talk about structured products. They will say I'll get you 24% return, 19% return. Assured as a, they will say, okay, it is linked with index, it is linked with that. Finally, he says that any Ashwagandha can only be 7 or 8%. Anybody talking in Ashwagandha beyond 8% is not possible. Because there is no rocket science. There is a rocket science, I would like to learn that. So, be very careful about the policy, about the people who are dealing with negative terms. Every practice of Julian and all, like Julian used to be the first year, 40% of the share. Most of the banks were selling Julian. All multinational banks, their whole staff were selling Julian. And it is much easier for them. Because every 6 months the guy changes. He performs, he gets incentive, he gets promoted, or he leaves the job, goes somewhere else, and starts abusing the same product. Because he has no set client. He is going to the client of the bank. In that process, who's going to be getting affected? Banks. Who's getting cheated? The investor. At least you should not be such an investor. As I said, wealth for all. I'm only taking concepts so the details will follow. Your day-to-day cash, ensuring that your life is not disturbed. For security, for meeting your commitments, for legacy, for helping, settling your children. When I said at that point of time, I didn't mean that we should not do that. But we should protect ourselves first and only surplus all the risk money which we have returned and the back to the and after that again I'll come back and talk to you.
Good morning. Mr. Jain has already told the importance of how important is financial prudence. I'll be very quickly taking you to 10 slides or so. We are going to be talking about different asset classes. As you are all bankers, you already know what are the different asset classes, what are their returns. So I'll be talking about what are the different asset classes, what are their returns after tax, why, what kind of mix we should make. The different asset classes. Wealth management is all about allocating your wealth into different asset classes. And so, the different asset classes are property. So, Jain has already told how important it is to have property, but how to limit the investment in property. We have clients who say we have 80% property and now we don't have any value because it will grow by itself. Agreed. But property has its own pros and cons, which I will talk in the subsequent slides. Then there are debt funds, debt investments like FDRs, which you all know, tax-free bonds, mutual funds like given mutual funds, guild, bond funds, NSEs, companies fixed deposit, senior citizens savings schemes, post office deposits, Kisan Vikas Patra, MIPs, again from mutual fund basket, NPs from pension plans. So these are all debt products, which give you around 7 to 9% return, and they have tax implications. There's no big tax rate. Only mutual funds in long term are subject to only 10% tax without indexation benefit and 20% with indexation benefit. Equity is the mutual funds, equity mutual funds, shares, and commodities like gold, silver. Again, they have their own problem bonds, which we'll be talking in subsequent slides. Suggested asset distribution from risk point of view. When we say risk, low risk. Low risk means person who can take low risk because of their age, maybe because of their some financial commitments, because of any other cash flow requirements or something. This will try to distribute ratio-wise in different asset class, which I've talked in my earlier slide. But this may not be a very, it's a model kind of thing which you can always, adjust according to your needs. Let me say a low risk taking person should only block 30% of his wealth in property because he needs liquidity, he needs some cash flow. Debt mutual funds or debt products like FDRs, FDRs also he can time in such a manner that they can give you monthly inflow if he needs a cash flow. Then NSEs, KPP, they can be adjusted in a manner you can get a cash flow out of it. And this is the money which you can park for short term. Short term NSEs, 1 to 3 years. Liquid funds again can be parked for a day or a year. Bank balance, you should always keep some bank balance.
maybe we'll earn 4% return or so at for contingencies. So we have said that 35% of a low risk taking person can keep in debt funds. For equity, he can invest 30%, that corpus which he can leave for 3 to 5 years and much more. But the basic thing is it should not be less than 3 years. And we'll be proving that if you invest for less than 3 years, you can lose the capital also in equity. And that's where the fear comes. But for long term equity, because this is an asset class which can give you more than 20% return also. And that too, that's it. Commodities, gold, and we will be talking about the returns. So 5% can be blocked in all this. This is a kind of low risk, then we have talked for medium risk and the high risk in the same manner. A high risk person who can take high risk because he has no financial commitments, he can block the money for longer duration, his cash flows have been taken care, he can block 60% of his money in equity. Because own use also comes in this. The whole property. Because we are saying you should keep property for your own use first. Investment in property. For investment
property. Own use property must take away from.
Yeah.
No, but that's a wealth.
That's a wealth, but that's a city.
Okay. But
beyond like one property everybody needs
to stay.
Beyond the first property, then you want to change.
So generally we take out house.
Does it mean the amount invested or
the
market value or the present value?
The market value of your debt. But here we have got on the market value. Property, of course, you know, it has
to
be
a value. Because of the sheer appreciation of the property, even if just one house or two houses, the property will be maybe 60, 70.
But that's the notional value, you know? That is
kind of low. One person purchased property 5 years back or 8 years, 10 years.
But now the value must have gone
up.
Yeah,
then
you need to adjust according to
that.
Yeah, of course.
Today I am not going to invest in property.
So this circle, he will be virtually empty. Depending on the quantum of wealth, the periodicity is decided. You rightly said that subject to market forces, there will be imbalances. It's time to adjust the balance. Maybe in your case, every 3 years, you need to look at these issues. Or if something has changed dramatically, like your investment is 60% in, say, equity, and in this 2 years, this 60% has become virtually, say, 90%. It's time to liquidate 30%, put it into debt, increase your quantum. The fundamental principle of portfolio management is that what I have earned is money in my pocket. I have to look at my portfolio on a daily basis. I can't say, 10 years back I bought this share for 10 rupees and today if it is at 30, I am very happy. If it has gone to 200 rupees in between, I should see that finally I have lost from 200 to 30. I am not saying look at daily, but do look at it quarterly at least. Do look at it 6 months basis at least, particularly the liquid assets. Property. You have to see that suppose your property has gone 10 times. Maybe you may like to, as an investment decision, you may like to say, okay, fine, this is mature. That's where your internal calculation and your free cash flow will help you. And you say, let me sell this and reinvest into one another property and part of this, let me put into security of like debt and all that. So profit booking is an integral part of wealth. If you are not going to book profit, we are not going to get exceptional gains. Exceptional gains always comes by booking profit. You are absolutely right that if things go beyond these proportions, we need to bring that back to these proportions. There could be a situation where I have one shop, that shop has gone 10 times, it has totally made the ratios heavy, and I don't want to sell that shop. One way could be that I sell that shop and buy another shop of upper value. Second is I say the hassle of selling a shop, buying a new one could be too painstaking. Maybe at that time you live with this, but with a conscious mind. Next, I have initiated the ratio. In next 1 year, next 2 years, next 3 years, I bring that back to my standard and model ratio. So a review, a constant review is a must.
Okay.
This was long term, I think quarterly or half yearly support.
So maybe
for long term.
For long term and all you can do is once in a year or once in a year. It could be good. Until and unless exceptional factors are there. Sometimes exceptional factors are the market has gone 100% in 3 years. Only you need to do zero at that point.
So driving
there is a day floating around, no? That your investment in equity should be 100 times your age. Okay.
That's about the risk profile.
Yeah.
The reason for that is, at the age of 20, you can put even 80%. The reason is simple, that you're earning, your risk-taking ability is high because you have a job.
Potential for earning is high.
And you have a job. You have but at the age of 80 or at the age of 60, but that is only for equity. We are talking about wealth management. That ratio does not take into consideration the commitment of the person. Now, take a simple person, 20 years of age. But he has to send his money home. So see, when he shall be only. He cannot afford to invest in equity. Because he is accumulating money in his salary.
People like us now at this stage, do you recommend that 40%? And I said, okay, I had a loan from the bank. I said, why should I take the loan? Yeah, I liquidated 50% of my investment at 6,000 rupees. Now I'm regretting, I should have taken the additional loan, kept the equity.
But what about the investment which is efficient for your plans or building?
No. I could have taken a loan here from the bank. Additional loan. I could have easily taken. I didn't take the traditional loan. Actually, Professor Pratip Chaudhary was the CGM in Chennai. I was the GM. He said, hey, mat karo. Don't sell your equity. I sold 50% of my equity. And how much I got? Only 2 lakhs. 50% of my equity.
2006, 2004, 2005. Is related to the growth of the economy of the country and also the world. Because finally everything is related. Stock market depends on 3 things. Cash flow in the market. Like suppose tomorrow, even if Indian economy is not doing well, but FII finds that there is no other place to invest in the globe, and India is the only place to invest, you will see tons of money coming at the stock market booming. Global economic situation. If globally economies are not doing well, even Indian economy may not be able to do that well, because now we have become a very closely knit economy. I won't be able to export if Europe is sinking by various industries which are export-oriented in some. If China is sinking, the commodity prices will fall, like it has fallen in the last 1 year. If the commodity prices will fall, whether it is Tata Steel or state, they can't perform well. And finally, is your domestic market. So you have to look at all these 3 factors. If one looks at all these 3 factors today are very heavily positive for India. I'm taking 2 more minutes extra, or maybe 5 minutes extra, to explain this point because it is very important. See, a fear of 2000 can be created in a fear only. It's not a reality.
It has happened?
Sir, it has happened because at that time 2400 and that was 2008. Like within what time it got recovered? Within 6 months it was again back to 5000. I'm talking Nifty, I'm not talking about Sensex. Now if you look at where we stand today, the demographics of the world. Europe has 46 years, China has 46 years. Now if your average age of people is 46, that means people above 60. Are in plenty. Their consumption pattern is different. They don't consume much. They don't buy clothes. They don't buy food. They don't do too much of those things. What they do, they buy medicines. So what happens when such and the working hands are not there? India has a demography of average age of 25 with 1.25 billion people. The policies with the government, I'm not saying. And I'm not commenting on the government per se, but the policies which this government has adopted, whether it is Make in India, whether it is defense production, whether it is you know, housing for all, whether it is roads. The kind of initiatives which has taken place 1.5 years back, which has started yielding results. The spending in the next 5 years is around 35 lakhs crore. If that kind of spending is going to come, you can see pure desh ka darsha badal gaya. And the whole world today is only looking India as a destination where they can make some money.
So again, but they have no taxes.
I am just taking up what I have invested over the last 3 years.
Okay.
My average rate of return on the tax reward is 7.98.
That
is what I invested last year.
Not 7.4.
Yeah, 7.4.
That is also something I'm more than 83.
And safe also. Because
Madam, you are not highlighted the risk related in each investment.
Risk we'll be talking in the next slide, which is pros and cons. So there we'll be talking about the risk also. Mutual funds liquid 7.5 to 9%, then they are easy to handle, they are liquidated easily, the money comes in the bank next day itself. So if you have a short term money, instead of keeping it in bank at 4% or 5%, you can always invest it, then mutual funds. They have no entry and exit note right now. NSE is again 8.10% kind of return, minimum investment period is 5 years. And default is a debt products. They are low, is low actually. Then we are talking about equity mutual funds. Company fixed deposits, they give higher return, but then they are a little riskier because you have to do a due diligence of the company where you are giving the fixed deposit. Senior citizen savings scheme, 8.6%, 15 lakhs is a limit, so again it limits your. Then there are certain post office deposit schemes, 7 to 8%. Then there are some more like Kisan Vikas Patra money gets doubled in 9 years, 2 months. Monthly income plans, they invest 65% in debt, 35% in equity. They give around 89% because if the equity gives minus return also, then they are able to manage some returns.
What are the tax implications
of this? Again, debt taxation.
Debt taxation.
3 years and above, they are on that 10%, 20%, otherwise as per se, in short term. NDPs from pension plans, still this market has to be, because you have to choose a plan very carefully. In the past, they are giving 7 to 8% kind of return depending upon the scheme. Reverse mortgage, it's not a set class, we'll be talking about later. Equity mutual fund.
If you commute pension from an
shares and mutual funds, again, this will prove that they have given around 20% return in 5 years to 10 years, 15% kind of horizon. Again, as we have talked, we should have a long investment horizon for them. Commodities have given 9.7% because we have done a study on gold. Gold has given 9.7% in long term. Next slide, I'll be taking that. Property, the positives in the property are income is in the form of rental payments, which is maybe 2%, but you get rental payments, so that will make your other cash flows if you are not staying in that property. Less volatile as compared to investment in shares. Capital growth, the value of the property increases. The negative part is it is very, very less liquid. Whenever you go to sell it, maybe you will not get a good rate. High transaction costs are there, you have to pay brokerage. And then it's difficult to manage sometimes if you do not have a plan for. Next mutual fund, the positives are bonds with regular interest income gives higher returns than FDs. But they fluctuate on the interest rate movements and they are less liquid. Now they are listed on the, but some of the bonds, you know, which are not tax free, which are not listed on NSE, you have to pay for 10 years and the duration. Fixed deposits, it gives you regular interest income, but they are not tax efficient. They give, post tax returns are low, but as per slab, you have to sell out 30%, that's the job. Then they are less, early maturity has some cost. As a banker, I will not talk about it here. Debt mutual funds, they are highly liquid. Long-term taxation is low, which is now 3 years plus. Has indexation benefit, which is not enjoyed by FDRs or others, etc. The return maybe is according to the interest rate. It has a default risk because in turn they are investing in some money market instruments or some, you know, so it has a lower default risk, but it has that kind of risk and are interest rate risk. If we are going on a low risk.
Yes, also have to pay tax.
Sorry?
Yes,
10% for long term, but because of indexation benefit, it comes virtually nil. Because the cost of acquisition increases, they get that indexation benefit. So, if 3 years plus, your cost, the net effect is the virtually no tax. Gold, liquidity is brought in a form of ETF, so you can sell ETF, but that has own cost and fluctuations in prices there. Equity mutual funds, it's the best investment option to achieve good long-term returns. The thing is long-term. Management professional fund managers, it is less volatile as compared to shares. Direct shares versus equity mutual funds are less volatile because they have made a basket of certain shares. So all of the shares will not go down in a day. And liquid as a money comes in bank in 3 days. Whenever you put a redemption, they have to give the money in 3 days. And they are very transparent because they give the NAV on a daily basis. So you can see your portfolio on a daily basis. Unlike ULIPs and all, where they invest, they are not transparent. You don't know what is the value of investment on a daily basis. Here the NAV is declared on a daily basis. The negatives are high risk, as risk of 70%.
Last slide. Only for 1 minute. If you permit me, I think this will answer your case. This slide has been made with a lot of research. What it reflects is that if you take on a single year basis, the return given by various funds, and we have taken around 5 funds, in year 11 and 12, all the 15%, 22%, it is gold. 14, 15, they get 52. You will invest and you have the fear. The concept I said fear and greed. If fear will start coming in you, that, oh, I lost 11%, you may exit. And that's what the common investor does. The wise investor remains invested. He looks at the answer, which the man was asking 10 years back, that's your calculation. If you are convinced that these projects will come, if you are convinced that the global leaders will do something, whether it is Japan, whether it is Eurozone, they are all talking quantitative easing, so that their economy comes to. Finally, you see, things are going to improve. So if you are convinced of those sectors, 10 years down the line, I expect market to do very well. But there's no guarantee. Had there been a guarantee, that investment, like only 3% in India.
Guarantee all the sector, all banks are closed. Everybody will have gone there into the guarantee.
No, that's there. You see, that is what you have to see, that the government is doing something now to recapitalize the bank. They are taking steps and they will be doing something.
No, what I'm saying is that the guarantee of 20% CAGR, nobody will come to a bank.
Absolutely. No, there is nothing required.
Because nobody is coming to the bank because we are guaranteeing 8% of whatever the small amount is being.
These are, maybe you can make a portfolio 40-60. 40 can be equity, which can be, there for long. 60 can be FDR, which will give you peace of mind, some cash flows and regular flows. It's all about making a mix. We're not talking about one asset class, which is very, lucrative and that's it.
Yeah, Mr. Jain, since you're not covered, my question, can I ask them? I tell you. So the thing is that, you have been discussing this. You would have heard about the incident of this JP Morgan mutual fund. My question is this: how passive you can be as an investor in this? You have to monitor the portfolio of each mutual fund.
You see, there are two parts to it. It's not only about JP Morgan, it's about Temple. Many months later,
I just give the reason example.
But what happens is, and that's the reason when the gentleman here was asking how many funds we should invest, I said minimum 4. And in the larger case, we say that no fund will be having exposure more than 10%. No particular scheme will have exposure more than 5% or 7%. So when we talk about even debt scheme, even in the same fund, we might choose 2 or 3. In fact, the whole thing of JP Morgan, if you look at it, the fund manager to whom you trusted, has not lived up to that expectation. Finally, you are going to some fund manager or somebody you are going to trust. He has not taken those due diligence parameters of buying a security, he looked at only the corporate, he didn't look at the cash flow. The problem was not on the debt, the problem was on the cash flow, the timing of the debt.
Can I make a point?
You see, what happens is, there are two ways of planning. One is personal view and the second is profit. What we must understand is how mutual fund industry works and how mutual fund industry is regulated. Today the regulations on mutual funds is becoming more and more. If you think of Mirai, which has happened in 2008, think of JP Morgan, which has happened now, think of Pepperton, which has happened now. SEBI is also looking at these things. There is a default or some loss or some hit of 5,000 crore. It's a part of the system. Plus, the advisors you look for. You know, sometimes what happens is everybody thinks he's an advisor. I know both. When you have a good advisor, he does this job which you are expecting to do. He looks at the portfolio. He looks at where he has invested the money. He questions because the mutual fund comes to your distributor. He does not come to you. Because distributor is a 100 crore business or 500 crore business because he is looking for the larger money. If you give 10 lakhs or 50 lakhs or 20 lakhs, no mutual fund executive will come in. So it is also very important for you to understand that you are choosing the right advisor. At the end of the day, you have to build adequate, systemic checks and balances. If you have built systemic checks and balances, the chances of your going wrong will go and reduce very, to a very large extent. And even if they happen, then in fact, we don't go as half.
Of 7 to 14%, most of them. In 5 years, they were positive 8 to 14%. In 10 years, 14 to 20%. 15 years, 11 to 22%. In 20 years, 11 to 25%. So, as the horizon of investment increases, your return increases. So, this is the point we want to make in this slide. Property, in 10 years, 8 to 12%. 15 years, 8 to 12%. 20 years, 9 to 13%. Then of course it depends on the location and all, but this is a kind of general, data which we have collected and seen. ETF, gold ETF is a buy physical gold and keep, compared to gold only.
Bullion and points.
But they also have ETFs have calls because you buy from a broker, then you'll sell,
Is it gold? Actually, totally different. What is gold for your day-to-day needs? Gold for family?
Gold has two values.
What is gold is what you want to buy. You're using it also, projecting it also. That is one plus. And second is gold as an investment. We must understand how the gold pricing also takes place. Finally, gold is a precious metal coming out of mines. Gold mining industry and industries now this price will also come down. Now this last couple of months, price has gone up. It has not gone up because the international gold price has gone up. It's because dollar has become stagnant. Rupee has become weaker. Because finally you enter buying gold in international prices in dollar. So jo gold up ₹54 dollar mein convert karte the aaj agar wo ₹67 ho gaya, so you can well understand that 2025. So this particular asset class,
this is a dollar exposure.
Is a very big dollar currency exposure. So you have to think from that end. Plus now in today's time you have to even look from security end. Does it make sense to have too much of gold at home? How to handle gold? If you are talking ETF and all, then it's pure investment. And if you are looking long-term ETF and things like that, and it gives you 30 years horizon, 3% to 8% return, it's fluctuating. Because too many factors are leading to its fluctuation. Like we talk about gold jewelry. You don't know jewelry banaya jaye. Kitna laag mila diya, kitni mitti mila di, kitna usme genuine purity kya hai. He will say that it is 22 carat or 24 carat.
He's not a great. Actually, I'm not having good part of
home.
EFT could be there, but he's not giving you return. Better to put money
more.
See, this is exactly what I'm saying. Are we speculating? Are we speculating? Can we beat the market? Can we watch and can we fix and how the rest of the game? See, if you want to be expert of everything, then better we play the derivatives of currency. Or something else. There are plenty of products. How much complexity you can have. So, system wise it's much easier. Hindsight, everybody is expert. You're expert. Hindsight, you can tell that LDM is who reaches the credit. Now, it's one of the things. Now, one is not realizing that when he reaches the credit, he will not be able to get the answer. So, when it is returned, nobody knows. Nobody can beat the timings and nobody can predict the timings. And that is where the systematic investment plan comes into play. And that's where the long term view comes into play. If you're talking long term, the correct fundamentals will give you the basis. It may not happen in 1 month, it may not happen in 1 year, but 10 years down the line, 15 years. In fact, I was talking about I diverted at that time. In 2004, Fortune, Warren Buffett had an analysis. Of US economy. And he made a block of 18 years, right? Starting from 1900 on. And he related that in 18 years block, there was a clear correlation between GDP growth of US economy and stock market growth of US economy. So if you talk about growth, GDP growth of 10 years or 15 years block, you can relate it to your own stock market. So the key is, are we confident about our economy? Are we confident that the economy will grow at 7-8% or so? Are we confident that these projects will take shape? If we are, market is for us. If we are not, then we put money on debt. And on debt also, then there is no security. Because if the economy fails, if the country fails, if there is a law and order situation, then say, what are you
doing? Good report. Good report. Good report. I don't know. 5,000 rupees at 20 or 24 lakhs, or 20. If you make it to 10,000, in today's time, 5,000 looks like peanuts. If you can spare that much money out of your cash flow, my strong advice is follow. If you follow this, at the age of 75, when your activity could be a little lesser, it could be a big money available, and it could be available for that. Equity is the main asset class which can beat inflation. Thanks. All other asset classes, they give you 1 or 2 or 3% more than the inflation. Because the economic concept of cost of capital itself says that return on your capital should be 1 or 2% more. Western countries, when the inflation is virtually insignificant, you find the return on investment is virtually insignificant. It won't happen even in India because the concept, economic concept won't change. So, look at this aspect from this angle. Now we are moving towards advice which will flow to you, which you can take back home. So, putting 5,000, 10,000 rupees in form of 6, maybe 3 or 4 funds. Or different timing, maybe 7, which are putting 4, 7, 15, 22, and 30. So, different dates so that you are picking up the rate at all the time. Yes, we'll talk about those points also.
Right now we're talking about
particular points. No, we want to go with
other points. So, Mr. Jain, you are meaning at this stage of life, you should invest in, say, for the transfer?
Yes, provided you have the cash flow surplus. After enjoying and doing what you want to do, if your cash flow is a shortage, then there is a difference. Then we'll talk about difference. But if cash flow is surplus and your day-to-day cash flow or your needs are met, think of it. Because still it's not too late. What you have not done in the last 25 years, you should start needing now. Then okay, utna minimum to aa raha hai, utna assured hai. I don't need to play with that, but now, the answer to this question lies in your hands. You have to decide. What is your progress? how well you can run your business. Will you be lured by greed and fear? Will you get influenced by the moment? Do you want ups and downs in your blood pressure? Do you want that your mood swings with the market? But those are decisions you all only have to take. But if I have been not like that, if for the last 29 years I have only thought about bank and only bank, and I have not done anything on my personal thing of building the bank or for building, planning my personal, don't venture it out now. It's not the time to venture.
Sir, as you said, now you have won the
I said that position. Sir, you are from Treasury. All are not.
And one more thing, you are the man at the
foundation.
That is how you will be able to invest put in the
other. Absolutely.
My submission is commendation is more related to two factors, your life expectancy. If you feel that I am very healthy and you will live more than 10 years, something like that, and then don't go for the secondly.
No, but I understand that 15th year onward. You still get, you get restored and you get full pension. So, you know, that factor gets over.
And secondly, one more thing, I am getting tax-free compensation. Whereas the income which I earn, otherwise the full pension,
well, he's saying is that whether it's the tax-free you're getting, but you lose that principle by investing erroneously.
What is the kind of return you will get on that 12 lakhs or 13 lakhs or 10 lakhs which you will get?
Very
many
might say, whatever.
Even if I put an RBI, I will get 6%.
Sir,
you can RBI, you can
withdraw
6%. But discounting 8% is
other,
say.
Then how does it make sense?
No, not discounting, it is getting discounted. At a rate which is higher than your taxable income.
Things like tax-free bond, or you are able to put in some mutual fund balance, or you are able to put in some mutual fund balance. Very good. Your bank deposit is not worth currency in your market.
Yeah. For some portion of your wealth, you can take some risk. And I want to add on, as you are saying, emergency fund, so already you have to make a mix, 60-70% should be debt fund, which can meet your, any kind of emergency. And what we are advocating is only 20-30%, which you do not for some time horizon, should
yeah,
be kept
in debt. Yeah,
I think that, because we said
you cannot be as good as getting money out of the bank the same day.
Right. After 3 days you get money, then you know the value, and you can always, with you work is other investment.
And the basic assumption is that you have established your financial commitment in terms of quantity and in terms of time. That means you know, at least for the next 5 or 10 years, what kind of funds you need, and what kind of income will flow, and what kind of expenses you will like to incur. You have established your regular cash flow, like pension, other accruals, rentals, etc., and have worked out your shortages or excesses. Because if you have not worked out your shortages and excesses, things can't move forward. In case of shortages, one needs to see what wealth is existing and what retirement fund one is getting, and how it needs to be deployed so that the shortfall I have can be met. And I don't need to wait to enjoy the wealth or the work I have done, or I don't need to worry about legacy. Presently, the return on liquid is 8 to 8.5%. With interest rate coming down, we expect the next 1 to 2 years, the return on liquid may come around 7.7 gross and 7% net of taxes, presuming that we will be remaining invested for 3 years. And there is a reason for that when I talk about systematic withdrawal plan to meet the shortages, that how this money can give you an effective 7% return. We have assumed tax on debt and liquid funds at 10%, as I said. And the case study has been prepared with a very conservative approach by investing in debt asset class. So when I'm talking about numbers here, we are working more towards debt asset class, a return of around 7%. But seeing the individual situation, you can safely take that if you're taking an advice of 5 to 10 years and taking a product mix of maybe 60-40 or something like that, you may be able to make an average return of 12%. Because somebody gives you 15-17% return, somebody gives you 7% return, and effectively, your average rate of return will be 12%. So with this, I'm making this case study. So I'm starting with having financial commitments have good wealth and safety. Now people can relate themselves and workers can be changed. We are looking at investment of say around 1.25, property 3.75, and some other properties in one has that can be added to build it. Self-occupied property is making more wealth. The importance of self-occupied property here is that if I have no commitment, and I have a cash flow shortage, I can go to reverse mortgage. So, you all are better and I don't think I need to explain reverse mortgage. Because the belief we have is that children are doing well, they don't need anything, they have their own earning capability. Let me enjoy myself. And the shortfall is I can meet toward reverse mortgage by still living in the same. We are talking about, for the sake of assumption, we have taken around 80,000 rupees pension. Individuals can adjust, their own data. We are taking a private corpus of around 75 lakhs. I see one thing.
I don't get the maximum pension. I think my last pension is before taxes in the 8,000.
Both of the cases. But having good wealth and savings. So I have a saving of 1.25 crore in investment, the property of 3.7% occupied, pension, safe factors basically. Here we can think of putting more money in equity. Now that's the scenario which will apply. Where I need to put money in equity so that because I have surplus. Let the surplus earn better return so that I leave a better legacy for my children. Or even after 75, if I require more money or I have more medical bills or if environment changes, because I'm going to touch upon the medical insurance piece also. Today it is there, today they are talking group insurance, 10 years down the line, 30 years down the line, how it works, these are all questions. So you need to prepare yourself even for those. So the view is that particular case where you have surplus. Try to deploy at a place where your return is substantially better than the inflation.
When you are suggesting for
as I said, there can't be one solution for all. Everybody will have their own solution. It's a good asset class, and you can consider this when you make your asset class.
Now, even
though you have different components. And that's how they used to do the budget. And my belief is that all proverbs and sayings of past, they hold value today also. He buy a car of 4 lakhs. And third, he buys a car of 10 lakhs. And the 10,000 which he was paying every month, he puts it into his EMIs. Now in the first instance, his 4,000 and his 6 makes a total at the age of 10 years, 23 lakhs, 45 years age, 68 lakhs, at 60 years of age, let's say 4 lakhs into car, end of the matter, closed. Third, 10 lakhs of rupees, it does 4 lakhs in 5 years, we said after 5 years he stops. The argument could be, he wants to live nice, so what's the problem? You know, let him invest 10 lakhs. Now that is there.
What you are saying is he should be aware of these options.
Absolutely.
And then take it call.
Take it call.
Is the right vision for him.
Absolutely. Because he has to see the earning, he has to see the future growth, he has to talk about, it should not happen at the age of 60, he says, I have no saving.
Then you go to a
20 lakh car. Absolutely, today's boy, today's children, what he's lucky car will be. You are right, absolutely right.
Early investment.
But that is what I think we need to inculcate in them. We need to tell them the power of business, power of that. And if they do that, we are talking about passive income, continuous review of passive income. We need to see that the passive income is increasing by passage of time. We need to also see that the passive earning which is there is also in this trend. And as I said, we need to understand the power of compounding. Past-time ke perspective mein compounding bahut choti lagti hai, but wohi 7 saal ho jata hai, to wo compounding bahut nahi hai. Value creation, sorry, I just trust and all our issues, trust and all our options of succession. But getting good trustee, who will do what you want to do, will also be very important. So individual cases need to be looked at very, very importantly by the individual. You are only 60, you still have a lot of time to do. Start thinking of that today, so that in the next 3 to 5 years, you can plan that out. And, sorry. No. Yeah, absolutely. True wealth, and that also you have to be talking about in a very clear manner. But even if you are going to do true wealth, you have to structure your wealth in such a way that it is separate, it is meeting your intent. But suppose you put all your money into one property, say 50 crore worth of property, and 3 children, and you are saying, okay, one third, everybody would be there. So maybe the option is I sell this house, create 3 properties, or do something else. It's a total individual decision, I mean. But I'm only making one point. Start thinking of that now. The solution will take 5 to 7 years. These things take time. It's not a rocket science that you have to decide for time. So, really. Because existing asset class also takes time. The market proportions, there are timings, there are a lot of issues which will not allow you to make change in your life.
You talked about low risk, medium risk, high risk. No risk, any options are
there? Yeah?
No risk. Keep money, keep home in a locker.
I suggest all my clients a simple way. Today to draw, in case of anything to me, everything goes to my wife or the spouse, vice versa. Only problem is in case everything happens, your flight, the whole family flight, and the plane crash. What do you do? So think of those worst scenarios also. But before coming to that, it gives me a lot of motivation to do. Amitabh, psychology is sangharsh ka khatam hota hai. Ek statement jo mere liye bahut moral deta hai. और मुझे पूछ देता है जिंदगी जब तक है तब तक संघर्ष है. तो नो रिस्क
नो लक
हो ही नहीं सकता. एवरीथिंग हैज अ रिस्क बट संघर्ष है उसका सोल्यूशन भी है. हर चीज का सोल्यूशन है. टफ टाइम आता है वो भी निकल जाता है. तो आई थिंक विद दिस इफ देयर नो मोर क्वेश्चंस आई एम समिता.
थैंक यू
वेरी मच. थैंक्स अ लॉट फॉर द पेशेंस एंड आई अप्रिशिएट. Thank you.